Welcome to Big Datapedia. So today we are going to discuss an Apache Afro Hands-on using Spark Summit operator on Windows subsystem for Linux environment. So I am using 18.4 Ubuntu Windows subsystem. So there we are going to submit our Spark Summit operator and we'll see the hands-on now. So I just opened the Ubuntu environment. And before that we just see the data. So I have right mssql.py file that already I just copied here. So here you can see it will be going to inject few data to SQL Server environment. So that is the flow. I have created a dummy data frame with a recent timestamp with respect to x and y, XYZ and ABC values. So to record each time whenever I'm going to execute this job is going to be loaded into this SQL server. That is I'm trying right now. So let's go with a little hands-on. Spark-submit write MS-SQL server. So while it's executing it, it's going to be loaded into this environment. So demo is a database and it's going to be loaded into Afro SSMS table. Just show here. So Afro SSMS table is going to be load the data. Now it's running now. I'm just using local environment. So job has been started and we don't have any data already, we have verified. So now this data is going to be injected into this DB. Okay, both are same record only, it's going to be injected now. So again I just execute the same script. And it's again it's going to be read the recent data and insert into this table. Okay, so recent data additionally just appended. Okay, now it's I'm going to schedule this job in Afro scheduler. Okay, so this is the data and already I have developed the code for Afro DAG. So in this DAG I'm using Afro Spark SSMS table and I'm using this application where the code actually is available for the Spark submission, and I'm using Spark Summit operator. I just imported and using now, and I just mentioned the task ID is Spark submissions. Okay, so DAG will be getting from here and every 1 minute is going to be executed, and I just mentioned the config with the application details. So this is the data, I just copied this code and go to this environment and I just go to the Afro DAX folder. So here I just create one file, nano Afro SSMS.py. There I just copy the file. Whatever, I just copy the content, I just paste into this file and save it. Now the file is available with respect to the data value. I just go back and execute now Spark scheduler. So Afro scheduler I'm going to execute in 8081 port number. And I'm pausing my postpad. Okay, so now successfully web server just get started. Again I'm going to schedule, execute the scheduler as well. So both will be just executed and getting follow. Now I just going to see in 8081 port number. Yeah, we have the data. So Afro underscore Spark underscore SSMS is I just mentioned with the value. Here you can see in the code. So DAG ID I just mentioned as Afro Spark SSMS. That's you will be seeing here. Just open it and spark submission is the task ID I just provided. So it will be reflecting right now. Now I just trigger it. So every 1 minute it's going to be executed. So 7:56 is just started. Okay, now it's running. So still running. And before that, I'm just going to truncate the table. First to see whether the data will be injected. Yeah, the data is injected in this time being. 7:56 data is injected. Now I'm just going to truncate it. Just truncate the table. And see, I don't have any data right now. So one is success. So after the success, I just truncate the table. So again, it's repeatedly is going to be executed. So second job is sorted right now and executing. Okay, so second job also completed. Just going to see the data. Okay, so 1957:25, the record was inserted, two records as per the Spark submission score. So again, third job is still running now because every 1 minute I just scheduled. So third job is completed, right? Okay, so two times injected. First time whenever it's injected, I just truncate the table. So two times it will be the data we can see here. That's it. So we will be connect back again with the different hands on. And please provide your valuable comments that will help us to improve our skills and training. Thank you.